Hello everyone, and welcome back to Cradle Roll Sabbath School. I hope you're all well. It's lovely to see you all. And we are now in a new month. We are in the month of February. So, we have a new programme and a new story for this month. I hope that you enjoy worshipping with us wherever you are in the world. And thank you for tuning in again and joining us in our Sabbath School. Let's start our programme together. It's lovely to come and be part of Sabbath School, isn't it? I'm so happy to see you all here. I wish that I could come and see you and give you a big hug through the screen, but sadly I can't. Did you know there's so many ways of saying hello to each other? For example, we could wave, we could give a big hug, we could give a high five, or we could go and shake someone's hand. Have you ever gone and shaken someone's hand? Is there anyone in the room that you could go and shake a hand with? We can go and sing Shake a Little Hand and welcome everyone to Sabbath School. So go around the room and shake everyone's hands. Are you ready? Shake a little hand and say good morning. Shake a little hand and say good morning. Shake a little hand and say good morning. We're glad you came to Sabbath School. Oh, wonderful. Did you greet everyone? Well, I think because I can't go and say hello to them, but how about you go and shake their hands for my behalf, yeah? Okay, let's sing one more time. Ready? Shake a little hand and say good morning. Shake a little hand and say good morning. Shake a little hand and say good morning. We're glad you came to Sabbath School. Welcome to Sabbath School, everyone. Let's have a really good Sabbath together. It's nice to have some nice things, isn't it? You could have some very nice toys, or some nice food, or even, maybe like me, some nice dollies. These are my really nice rabbit dollies, and I have two of them. Oh, but you don't have anything there. Oh, I'm sorry, these are my dollies. But it's a bit rude of me to keep them to myself, isn't it? Isn't it nice to share things with one another? Have you got anything at home that you could share with someone? How about I share my dollies with you and you find something to share with someone at home? Maybe with a brother or a sister or with mummy and daddy. Go and find something like my dollies and we can share our things together. Let's go share some toys. And now that I'm sure you have something to share, let's share our toys together. Ready? I have some toys and I am glad. You have no toys and that's too bad. I'll share my toys 'cause I love you. And that's what Jesus wants me to do. Did you share your things? Oh, I'm so proud of you. Jesus would be so happy. Well done for sharing your toys. I have something else to share. What do I have here? Some boats. Do you have any boats at home? You don't, but that's okay. I can share my boats with you. How about you go and find something else to share and then we can share our toys together. Are you ready to share? I have some toys and wonderful to share things. Jesus will be so proud of us that we shared our toys together. Can you see what this beautiful thing is that I have hanging up here? What do you think it might be? That's right, it's a heart. We all have a heart, don't we? Deep in here. Now, I wonder who's inside of your heart. Shall we find out who's inside this heart? Let's open the doors to this heart. Who's inside of this heart? Can you say who that is? Who's inside this heart? That's right, it's Jesus. Now, is Jesus in your heart? I hope and pray that he is. He's definitely in my heart. So I think we should sing Into My Heart. We're going to ask Jesus to come into our hearts. Are you ready?
Into my heart, into my heart, come into my heart, Lord Jesus, come in today, come in to stay, come into my heart, Lord Jesus.
And with Jesus in our hearts, do you think that our lives would look a little bit different? In fact, it would make us so much better. So we're going to ask Jesus to shine out of our hearts now. Are you ready?
Out of my heart, out of my heart, shine out of my heart, Lord Jesus, shine out.
Everyone. It's wonderful to have Jesus in our hearts, isn't it? I think that it's time to talk to Jesus, don't you? So, let's put our hands together, close our eyes, and let's talk to Jesus. Dear Jesus, thank you for looking after us. Thank you for being with us and keeping us safe. And that you love us, Lord. And Lord, we love you too. Please be with us and all the lovely children around the world and their families. Continue to protect us and guide us and keep us safe until we all meet again. In your name I pray. Amen. Well done. It was lovely to talk to Jesus, wasn't it? Wonder what the weather's like today. How do we find out what the weather's like? I know, could someone go to their window and have a look? I wonder if it's raining, or sunny, or windy, or snowing. What's the weather like today? I hope it's very nice weather where you are. But what if it's raining? Raining is sad. Means we can't go outside unless we put our welly boots on. But actually, rain is a lovely thing, because what rain does is it waters the ground. It waters the plants, so we have pretty flowers, fruits, and vegetables, which of course we like to eat, don't we? So the rain is actually a sign of God's love. So let's sing, "The raindrops fall with a pitter pitter pat." I want to see your raindrops falling with a pitter pitter pat, showing God is love. Are you ready?
The raindrops fall with a pitter pitter pat, pitter pitter pat, pitter pitter pat. The raindrops fall with a pitter pitter pat, showing God is love.
Oh, good job! Rain is lovely, isn't it? And I love the pitter pitter pat that it makes as it falls. I think we should sing that song again. Are you ready with your raindrops? Ready with your raindrops? Let's sing.
The raindrops fall with a pitter pitter pat, pitter pitter pat, pitter pitter pat. The raindrops fall with a pitter pitter pat, showing God is love.
Good job, everyone. Even if the rain means we might have to stay indoors, it can actually do so many good things for the outside world. So the rain really does show God's love. Now, those that do come to Cradle Roll Sabbath School are usually little ones. Are you one of my little ones out there? Can you put your hand up if you're one of my little ones? There you are! All my lovely little children. Now, when you come to my Sabbath school, we like to sing a song about Jesus loving us, because we're the little ones. So can you show me Jesus loves the little ones, like me, me, me? Ready to sing? Let's sing Jesus loves the little ones. Jesus loves the little ones like me, me, me. Jesus loves the little ones like me, me, me. Little ones like me, sat upon his knee. Jesus loves the little ones like me, me, me. Good job, everyone. He really does love us little ones, doesn't he? But it's not just us little ones that come to Sabbath school. I wonder if you come with someone else. Can you think who that person might be? Maybe people. Don't you come with Mummy and Daddy? So, are Mummy and Daddy little ones? Oh no, they're grown-ups. But does Jesus love them too, because they're not a little one? Of course he does, because Jesus loves the older ones, like you, you and you. Let's stand up, turn around, face our parents, and let's sing Jesus loves the older ones. Are you ready? Jesus loves the older ones like you, you, you. Jesus loves the older ones like you, you, you. Older ones like you, Jesus loves you too. Jesus loves the older ones like you, you, you. Excellent job! Well done! Jesus loves every single one of us, whether we're big or small. We've now come to the time where we come and bring our pennies for Jesus. Have you got your pennies ready? I've got mine ready right here. Look, I've got my pennies ready and my penny pot. So I think it's time that you should go and get your pennies and your penny pot and we can do our offering together. Are you ready? Have you got your pennies? Then let's sing Hear the Pennies Dropping and come and bring your pennies for Jesus. Hear the pennies dropping, listen while they fall. Everyone for Jesus, he shall have them all. Dropping, 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 hear the pennies fall. Everyone for Jesus, he shall have them all. Well done! Have you put all your pennies in your penny pot? Well, I've put all of mine in, so I think I should put the lid on mine. There we go. And let's sing a prayer over our offering. We're going to sing Thank You for the World So Sweet. So, hands together, eyes closed, and let's sing.
Thank you for the world so sweet. Thank you.
Very good of you to come and bring your pennies for Jesus. Do you have a birthday this month? If you do, then stand up because we are going to sing you Happy Birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Jesus, my friend, may he guide you always.
Zacchaeus was a very small man. He lived in the city of Jericho during the times of Jesus. He was a tax collector working there. And because of this, many people didn't like him. A lot of people didn't like tax collectors, as they would sometimes make people pay more taxes than they needed to, but then they would keep the extra money for themselves. Zacchaeus would also do this, and because of that, he became a very rich man. But even though he had all this money, fine clothes, fancy food, and lots of lovely things to fill his big house with, Zacchaeus was still unhappy because he didn't have anyone to share all of his wealth with. One day, someone came to Jericho. He was telling everyone in the city how Jesus was coming to visit. Zacchaeus, like many other people of the time, had heard all of the amazing miracles Jesus performed and the stories he would tell to help people become better. Zacchaeus had also heard of the amazing power of Jesus and wanted to meet him. Zacchaeus thought Jesus might be able to help him become happy, and he could tell Zacchaeus what to do in order to be saved and go to heaven. But even though Zacchaeus really wanted to see Jesus, he didn't know if Jesus would want to see him. He thought that because many people didn't like him, Jesus would also not like him or want to see him. This made Zacchaeus very sad, but he decided that he would still try and see Jesus when he came to visit. When Jesus did come to Jericho, many people had followed him. There were so many people that a massive crowd had gathered around Jesus so they could listen to his teachings and stories. Because all these people were gathering around Jesus, Zacchaeus was not able to see him. He tried to push his way through the crowd or shout to try and get them to move so he could see. But no one listened or moved, and Zacchaeus was too short to see over anyone. No one liked Zacchaeus because he was a tax collector who would steal their money. Many of them told him to go away and that a good man like Jesus would not want to spend any time with a bad man like Zacchaeus. This made Zacchaeus very sad. He didn't want to be a bad man. He wanted to be a good man, and he wanted to meet Jesus so that he could tell him how to become a good person. He was about to give up and go home, but suddenly he saw a tree nearby. The tree was a big sycamore tree, and Zacchaeus thought if he climbed up it, he would be able to see Jesus. Zacchaeus decided that he really wanted to see Jesus, and he would do whatever it took to be able to hear him. He ran to the sycamore tree and began climbing it as fast as he could. Up and up he went, till he found a big branch that would give him the perfect view of Jesus. He slowly and carefully shuffled along the branch and sat down. He looked down and watched as Jesus was walking, talking, and teaching everyone who had come to listen. Jesus was walking closer and closer to the tree as he spoke to all of the people who had come. When he was under the sycamore tree, he looked up and saw Zacchaeus sitting in the branches. "Zacchaeus, come down! I'm coming to your house for tea," Jesus called up to him. Zacchaeus didn't need to be told twice, and he climbed down the tree twice as fast as he climbed up it. He greeted Jesus with excitement and took him to his house. Together they ate and spoke. Zacchaeus asked what he needed to do to become a good person. Jesus told him, "Give back to those you have stolen from. Do not collect wealth to keep only for yourself, but use what you have to help others. If you love God and you love me, you will love all of my children just as I have loved you." Jesus tells us that we need to help and love each other, just as he has done and continues to do for us. Every day, we need to do what we can to show love to those around us, and we can do that by using the gifts that God has given us to help others. Just like Zacchaeus, we need to do everything we can to see and be close to Jesus. We must always try to listen to what he tells us and do what he asks of us. Remember that God is love, and we must be like God by giving the love he gives to us unconditionally and passing that on to others.
Zacchaeus was a very little man. In fact, we can sing a song about him. So, I need you all to stand up, and I want you to pretend to be Zacchaeus, a very, very little man. Are you ready? Zacchaeus was a wee little man, a wee little man was he. He climbed up in a sycamore tree for the Saviour he wanted to see. And as the Saviour passed that way, he looked up in the tree and he said, "Zacchaeus, you come down, 'cause I'm coming to your house for tea. Yes, I'm coming to your house for tea." Oh, well done, everyone. Why don't we sing it again? And this time I want you to climb really, really high into that tree so that Zacchaeus can see Jesus. Are you ready? Zacchaeus,
was a wee little man. A wee little man was he. He climbed up in a sycamore tree for the Saviour he wanted to see. And as the Saviour passed that way, he looked up in the tree and he said, "Zacchaeus, you come down, 'cause I'm coming to your house for tea. For I'm coming to your house for tea." Well done, everyone. Zacchaeus did get to have tea with Jesus that day, and Jesus changed Zacchaeus's life. So always remember that God is always knocking at your door, wanting to see if we can let him in. And Zacchaeus let him in, and we should let him into our hearts too. We've now come to the time in our programme where we say our memory verse together. Have you learnt your memory verse for this month? You have? Well, why don't we say it together? Are you ready? Our memory verse this month is God. God written in red. Is written in orange. Love. Love written in yellow. And our memory verse this month is found in 1 John 4 verse 8. 1 John 4 verse 8, written in green. Well done. Shall we say our memory verse all together? After three. 1, 2, 3. God is love. 1 John 4 verse 8. Let's say it again. God is love. 1 John 4 verse 8. Well done, you learned your memory verse. How about we stand up and we sing I'm Glad I Learned My Memory Verse. Are you ready?
I'm glad I learned my memory verse. I'm glad I learned my memory verse. I'm glad I learned my memory verse on this bright Sabbath morning.
Well done, everyone. You learned your memory verse.
Are you happy today? I hope that you're happy today. Put your hand up if you're happy today. Oh, there's lots of you that are happy today. And there's so many reasons to be happy today. You could be happy because of the weather. You could be happy because you've done something fun. I'm happy because my Lord and Saviour loves me very much and he always looks after me. And that's one of the reasons I'm always happy. So I think we should sing a song about being happy. Let's sing If You're Happy and You Know It. Now there's lots and lots of actions to this song. So I need you all to stand up and get ready to do all the actions with me. Let's sing If You're Happy and You Know It.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it and you really If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. If you're happy and you know it, turn around, whee! If you're happy and you know it, turn around, whee! If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, turn around, whee! If you're happy and you know it, say amen, amen! If you're happy and you know it, say amen, amen! If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, say if you're happy and you know it, do all five. Clap, clap, stamp, stamp, nod, nod, turn around. Amen! If you're happy and you know it, do all five. Clap, clap, stamp, stamp, nod, nod, turn around. Amen! If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, do all five. Clap, clap, stamp, stamp, nod, nod, turn around. Amen! Good job, everyone! I hope you're happy after singing that song with me.
We have much fun today in Sabbath school, didn't we? We sang some songs, we had a great story, and we learnt our memory verse. So I think what we should do is we should close our Sabbath school with a prayer. So hands together, eyes closed, and let's talk to Jesus and end our Sabbath school. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you that we had so much fun in Sabbath school today, learning all about you and being able to be together even though we're apart. Thank you, Father, for all that you do, and please continue to keep us safe and well until we meet again. In your name I pray, amen. Our Sabbath school is over. Let's sing. Ready? Our Sabbath school is over and we are going to church. Goodbye. Today. It was so good to see you all, and I hope that you continue to remain safe, and I'll see you all next time. Bye bye. God bless. Bye bye.